Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we are supposed to start lesson 4. Before going to lesson 4, let's have a look on this slide, okay? Basically, Arabic grammar closely deal with the harakats. Harakat means dhamma, kasra, fataha, which includes dhammatain, fatahatain, kasratain. Okay? Depends on the haraka sometimes, right? Most of the time, the meaning of the sentence will change. For example, if you say Zaidun, okay? Zaidun. Zaidan. Zaidan. Zaidin. All these will give different meaning in a sentence. So we have to be careful. When we read Arabic, two things we have to be careful. One is makhraj. The second one is haraka. If you give wrong haraka, then the meaning will change. For example, khalaqallahu. Khala. Allah. Khalaqallahu means Allah created. Just notice this. Allah having Dhamma. Okay. Khalaqallahu means Allah created. Allah created the world, all the creations He created. Okay. Instead of Dhamma, if you give Fataha to the Allah, the meaning will be totally changed. For example, khalaqallaha. If you say khalaqallaha, then the meaning will be someone has created Allah. Khalaqallahu, Allah created the creation. Khalaqallaha, someone created Allah. So the is iman, between iman and kufr. If we say someone has created Allah, then it's kufr. Allah created the creation is a iman. So sometimes this haraka will decide our iman. So we have to be very careful with two things when we read Arabic. One is makhraj. Second one is haraka. Okay. So if you give wrong haraka, what happened? Allah is Allah. But instead of Dhamma, if you read in the Quran, khalaqallaha, then it's a kufr. We are saying Allah is someone who has created Allah. Okay. So we have to be very careful. Okay. How do we identify this haraka? Which haraka we have to go? We have to give where? Okay. By default in Arabic noun, right? We will give dhamma. You know, since the first lesson we are reading the nouns. Al qalamu, as sariru, qaimun, ar rajulu. By default, all the Arabic nouns will have dhamma. If you want to give kasra or fataha, there's supposed to be some reason. Without some reason, you can't give kasra or dhamma for a noun in Arabic. So next time, whenever you read Quran, if you see fataha in a noun, then there is some rules are applied there. That's why the noun got fataha or kasra. Got it? So there are many reasons. Inshallah, we will read those reasons. That is the grammar rules in Arabic. The grammar, Arabic grammar will teach us where we have to give the fataha, where we have to give the kasra, and whatever reason it comes in Arabic sentences. Today, inshallah, we will learn something, some reason when we have to give kasra to the a noun, to the noun, to a noun. Okay, today in lesson 4 we are going to see a grammar rule in which place, in which reason we have to give a kasra to a noun. Got it? You understand? Any doubts so far? Okay, let's go to the lesson now. الدرس الرابع. This is number 4. الدرس, the lesson, the lesson. الرابع means fourth, fourth lesson, the fourth lesson, lesson. Okay, here if you look at this word al-baytu, what is the meaning? Al-baytu, the house. Al-baytu, the house. You see here, fil baiti. The baitu become baiti here. Why? It's because of fi. It's because of fi. The fi is one of the preposition particle. Preposition particle means this fi will give the kasra to the following noun. In Arabic, there are three words. One is noun. Another one is verb. Another one is particle. Particle. Okay. We will call it as harf. In Arabic, we will say harf. Noun, we will use ism. We knew it. Fa'al is verb. Fi'alun. Fi'alun means verb. Fi is the one of the particle which give kasra to the following noun. So this fi is called as harful jar, one of the harful jar. There are few. Fi is one of the harful jar. We will say harful jar, jarri. Okay, shadda harful jar. Harful jar. Harful jar means the particle which gives jar. It's supposed to be jar, okay? Harful jarri. Which one? The fi is harful jar. Harful jar means this particle will give jar. Jar means kasra, okay? Jar means kasra. This particle will give kasra to the following noun. So this particle will called as harful jar. Particle means, you know, right? Kind of in or at. This will not give a meaning, but it will give meaning when it joins to the other words. Okay. Similarly, fi means in. Fi means in. Fi means in. Fi means in. Fil baiti means in the house. In the house. So when we use fi before any noun, we have to give kasra to the noun. Why? Is because fi is harful jar. Harful jar means particle of jar. Jar means kasra. The harf, the particle which give kasra to the following noun. Okay. Tell me three times. Harful jarri. Harful jarri. Harful jar. Okay. So al baitu means the house. Fil baiti means in the house. But the haraka for al baitu is dhamma, because the default haraka for any noun is dhamma. Here harful jar is came, so we have to give kasra to the following noun. Fil baiti. So hereafter, whenever you see fi, then you have to give kasra to the following noun. Fil baiti. In the house. In the house. Al masjidu. Al masjidu means the mosque. The mosque. Fil masjidi. In the masjid. In the mosque. Fi means in. We have to give kasra to the masjid because it's followed by a harful jar, which is fi. This one we have to read as a fi. Okay. Fi. Then yamadda. Fi. Here we have a alif lam, so we have to join this directly here. We silent this, fill. But normally, if you say harful jar, fi. Fi is harful jar. What is the meaning? The meaning is in. Okay. Fi is one of the harful jar. There are few harfs. Inshallah, we will learn it later. In this lesson, we will learn two harful jar, particle of preposition. The second letter is ala. The second letter is ala. Ala is also one of the harful jar which will give kasra to the following noun. Noun means ism in Arabic. Al maktabu, the table. The table. By default, a noun, a ism. Ism means noun. A ism will get dhamma. Alal maktabu, wrong. Alal maktabi. Alal maktabi. Because ala is one of the harful jar. So we have to give a kasra to the following noun. Alal maktabi. Alal maktabi. Ala means on. Going on. Okay. Alal maktabi means on the table. On the table. Al maktabu means the table. Alal maktabi means on the table. Ala means on. Al maktabi, the table. Alal maktabi, on the table. Similarly, look at the second example. As-sariru, the bed, the bed. Ala sariri. Let's try the meaning of this. On the bed. On the bed. Ala is harful jar. So sariru become sariri here. It's because of ala. Today we have learned two harful jar, which is fi, and second one is this is ala. Fi ala. Fi means in. Ala means on. Okay. Al baitu fil baiti. The house in the house. Al masjidu fil masjidi. The mosque in the mosque. Al maktabu ala al maktabi. The table on the table. As-sariru, the bed. Ala sariri, on the bed. Alhamdulillah. This is what we are going to practice in this lesson. Okay, we will have a small question and answers to practice this fi and our ala. Any doubts so far? So you understand what is harful jar and what it will do, right? Okay, let's go to B. Alif means section A. Ba means section B. Here we will have few question answer to practice this harful jar. Aina means where. Aina means where. Where. Okay. Aina Muhammadun. Where Muhammad. I have told you before. Is, was. There is no equivalent letter in Arabic to is and was. So Aina Muhammad means where is Muhammad. Okay. Where is Muhammad? Since here you look at a new word, huwa. Huwa means he. Huwa means he. You come to this word here. He, yeah. We have to give fatha to ya, okay? Here. Huwa means he. Here means she. Here means she. So totally three new vocabularies here in section B. One is aina. Aina means where. Huwa, he. Here, she. Aina, where, huwa, he, she. Okay. Aina Muhammadun. Where is Muhammad? Huwa fil ghurfati. Ghurfa means room. Ghurfa means room. Huwa fil ghurfati. That means he is in the room. Okay. Since fi is here, we have to give kasra to this noun. So don't say fil ghurfatu. If you say fil ghurfatu, it's wrong. Here you can say aina Muhammadun, aina Yasiru, aina Aminatu, Kitabu. But when a noun followed by a harful jar, then you have to give kasra to the noun. So since fi is here, we have to give ghurfati. Don't recite ghurfatu. Ghurfati. Aina Muhammadun huwa fil ghurfati. Where is Muhammad? He is in the room. And second one, wa aina Yasirun, and where is Yasir? Huwa, he is fil hammami. Hammam means bathroom, not toilet, it's a bathroom. Huwa fil hammami, he is in the bathroom. So hammam means bathroom. Since it's followed by fi, we have to give kasra to hammami. We have to give kasra to hammami. Wa aina Yasir? Where is Yasir? Huwa fil hammami. He is in the bathroom. Third one. Wa aina Aminatu? Wa aina Aminatu? And where is Amina? Where is Amina? Here fil matbakhi. Here fil matbakhi. She is, yep. Sajid?
I want to ask, do you know how it says Aina Muhammadun? There's thing, why is it Amina too? Like just one
thing. Good question, alhamdulillah. Inshallah, I will tell you. Oh. Here fil matbakhi. She is in the kitchen. Matbakh means kitchen. Okay. Aina Aminatu. Where is Amina? Here she is in the kitchen. In the kitchen. Kitchen is al-matbakhu. Here fi is followed by fi. So we have to give kasra to matbakh. Fil matbakhi. This is ta, okay? Then last one is khi. Fil matbakhi. Fil matbakhi. Okay. Here, we have learned, firstly, we have learned a harful jar rule. Number one, we have learned harful jar. Harful jar means those harf, it will give kasra to the following noun. Secondly, there is a rule, grammar rule, second rule. All masculine proper noun will have dhamma, dhammatain. Okay, that means tanwin, will carry tanwin. However, all feminine proper noun will carry only single dhamma, single kasra, single fataha. It won't carry the tanwin. Got it? This is the second rule. There is another one, third rule, inshallah. I will teach you now in the next two sentences. Okay. So that's why aina Muhammadun huwa, wa aina Yasirun, wa aina Aminatu. Okay. However, there are some exceptions where you can give just single dhamma, single kasra to a masculine proper noun. Those are exceptions, okay? Exceptions are exceptions. However, a common rule is all masculine proper noun will have tanween and all feminine proper noun will have single haraka, will not carry tanween. Got it? Okay. Then next, Ainal Kitabu. Ainal Kitabu. Where is the book? Wa Ainal Kitabu. Where is the book? And you look at the second question also. Wa Aina Saatu. Wa Aina Saatu. Kitabu means the book. Where is the book? And where Saat means watch. Particularly we will say a hand, we are wearing in the hand, right? Hand watch. Huh? Where is the watch? Saat. And hereafter also sometimes we will in hadith say asa means the here day of the judgment. Okay, that is different. In this lesson, asatu means watch. Huh? Where is the watch? Where, and now we will look at the answer. He is on the table. Here, he is on the bed. You know, right? Maktabi means table. Sariri means bed. Ala means on. But the question is, we are using he here and she here. Why? It's supposed to be it, right? It's supposed to be it, right? Aina Muhammadun, he is in the room. Aina Amina, she is in the kitchen. Aina Kitab, it is. But how come here they used he is? Some more here Asatu, she is. Confusing, right? Don't need to confuse. In Arabic, which is the third rule we are learning in this lesson. Okay, this is the third rule we are learning. This rule is very unique to the Arabic language. There are few things it's unique to the Arabic language. The other language will not contains those rules. For example, in count, right? If you look at one book, you will say it's a singular, correct? If you see two book, two plus books, you will say plural, correct? This is in Arabic, Tamil, and most of the languages are one is singular, more than one is plural. But in Arabic, there is a uniqueness in Arabic. Singular, doer, plural is starting from 3+. Okay, we will learn it later. This is the uniqueness of Arabic language. I hear that French also having a doer. French also having a doer in its language, but I don't know. But commonly, most of the language singular, plural. One is denotes to singular, two plus objects are denotes to plural. However, in Arabic, it's a special count will be divided into singular, dual, then plural. The plural will start from 3+, not 2+. Okay, this is a uniqueness. We will learn it later. Okay, second uniqueness is in Arabic is non-living things. Okay, non-living things will have, usually in all language, living things will have masculine, feminine, right? Masculine, feminine, we will apply to living things like man, cat, cow, monkey. So all the living things will have masculine and feminine. Non-living things like door, car, bus, house, madrasa, school, mosque, it doesn't have masculine, feminine in other language, correct? But in Arabic, non-living things also divided into masculine and feminine. How come, Ustad? How we identify which objects, non-living things object is belongs to masculine, which is belongs to feminine? Okay, it's by looking at a last letter of the word. Living things, we don't have issue, right? Yasirun, we know. Aminatu, feminine. That means cow, goat. We can identify masculine. This is masculine and this is feminine. But kitabu, how come we know book is masculine or feminine? Asatu, watch. How do we identify whether the watch is masculine or feminine? Okay, you have to look at the last letter of the word. By default, all the non-living things, nouns are masculine. Default, all non-living things, objects, nouns are masculine. However, those noun will contain few letters. One of the letter is ta marbuta. We will say this ta marbuta, right? Ta or this ta. We will call this taul muannas. Taul muannas means feminine ta. And another two is aliful mamduda, aliful maksura. Never mind, we will look at it later. But most of the time, you can identify those letters, those noun ending with ta marbuta is feminine noun. That's why al kitabu, they have used huwa, he. Okay? Because by default, all the nouns are masculine. So you don't need to have any identification. By default, it is masculine. But those noun ending with ta marbuta, and another one is aliful mamduda, aliful maksura. Okay. This is less, but mostly this is the commonly, predominantly, you can see most of the time, okay? So this saatu ending with ta marbuta, we consider this object, this noun is feminine. So we have used she. Okay. Regardless of huwa means he, here is she, when it applies to non living things, when you do the translation, you just use it, okay? Because it's not nice to say ainal kitabu, where is the kitab, he is in on the table. No, it is on the table, but you have to identify, understand that huwa is because of al kitabu is masculine, here is because of asatu is feminine, because it contains ta marbuta in the end of the word. At the end of the word. Got it? Any doubts? Okay. Aynal kitabu? Where is the book? Huwa alal maktabi. It is on the table. Huwa is because of masculine. Wa ayna sa'atu? And where is the watch? This one is just, they are giving the picture, okay? Out of the scope. It's just saying that this is matbakh, okay? We have to answer, come to here, okay? Aina sa'atu? Where is the watch? Hiya ala sariri. It is on the bed. Here we have used here is because of sa'atu is feminine. It's ending with ta. Got it? Any doubts? Any confusion here? Okay, good. Aina Muhammadun? Where is the Muhammad? Okay, let's read it together. Start, read it loudly. Aina Muhammadun? Where is Muhammad? Huwa fil ghurfati. Huwa fil ghurfati. He is in the room. Wa aina yasirun? Wa aina yasirun? And where is Yasir? Huwa fil hammami. Huwa fil hammami. He is in the bathroom. Wa aina Amina? Wa aina Aminatu? And where is Amina? Hiya fil matbakhi. She is in the kitchen. Aynal kitabu? Aynal kitabu? Where is the book? Huwa alal maktabi. Huwa alal maktabi. It is on the table. It is on the table. Wa ayna sa'atu? Wa ayna sa'atu? And where is the watch? Hiya ala sariri. Hiya, you have to read it. Hiya. Hiya ala sariri. It is on the bed. Okay, one more time. We will just read the Arabic and make sure you are reading loudly, okay? Aina Muhammadun with tanween, because all masculine proper noun will have tanween. All feminine proper noun will not have tanween. Aina Muhammadun huwa fil ghurfati, because of fi, harful jar. Wa aina Aminatu? Wa aina Yasirun? Wa aina Yasirun? Huwa fil hammami. Huwa fil hammami. Wa aina Aminatu? Wa aina Aminatu? Hiya fil matbakhi. Hiya fil matbakhi. Aynal kitabu? Aynal kitabu? Huwa alal maktabi. Huwa alal maktabi. Wa ayna as-sa'atu? Wa ayna as-sa'atu? Hiya ala as-sariri. Hiya ala as-sariri. Khair, alhamdulillah. Here we have looked at few new rules. Number one is harful jar. Number one is harful jar. Number two is all the masculine proper noun will have a tanween, and feminine proper noun will not have a tanween. Number three is non-living things also will have a gender in Arabic. There are gender for non-living things also, irrational noun. Rational in commonly in Tamil, in Arabic, sorry, Tamil or English or other language, right? Only rational things, noun will have gender. Living things will have a gender. Irrational things, non-living things will not have a gender. But in Arabic, irrational thing, non-living things also will have a gender. It's based on, divided based on the last letter of the word. If the last letter of the word ending with ta marbuta, we will call that noun is feminine. If by default all the non-living things noun are masculine, so no need to have an identification why this is masculine. No, by default all non-living things, irrational things are non-living noun. Non-living things, irrational nouns are masculine. But if you say this is feminine, you have to give some evidence. Why this is feminine? It's because of tamarbuta. Why this is masculine? Hey, don't ask me. Because by default, all non-living things are masculine. Okay? So this is number three. There are new grammar rules we have learned in this rule. Please note it down. This one we have to apply at all the places, not only in this lesson, hereafter whenever you see harful jar, you have to give the kasra to the following noun. And whenever you read masculine proper noun, you have to give tanween. Whenever you read feminine proper noun, you should not give tanween. Okay, then non-living things, you have to give masculine and feminine gender related things by identifying the last letter of the word. Okay, it's too much heavy. I don't think so. Good. If no questions, we will go to the next tamarin exercises. Okay. Tamarin exercises. Ajib anil as'ilatil atiyati. Ajib means answer. Ajib means answer. An means about. Okay, A, this is A. As'ila means questions, plural. Sualun means question, singular. As'ila, as'ilati means plural, questions. Al-atiyati means al-atiyati. Okay. Al-atiyati means following. Ajib anil as'ilatil atiyati. Answer the following questions. Don't need to give all the particles, right? You have to give the translation. Depends on the places. Okay. Don't need to say answer about the following questions. No need. Answer the following questions. Yes, Sajid.
Is an a harful jar?
Yes, alhamdulillah. That's why this as'ilati got kasra. An is also one of the harful jar. Al-atiyati, following this noun, okay? This, we will learn it later. Or what are the noun will follow the previous letter. Here, al-atiyati follow this kasra, okay? an is harful jar because of this an as'ilati got kasra. Good, alhamdulillah. Ajib anil as'ilatil atiyati. So whenever you see fataha or kasra in Arabic, that should be a reason. Ajib anil as'ilatil atiyati. Answer the following questions. Aina al-kitabu? Where is the book? Okay, later you take it as a today's assignment, homework. Okay, answer it. Aina Muhammadun? Here, see here. Aina, they never say Muhammadun. You have to say Muhammadun, because it is a masculine proper noun. All the masculine proper noun will have an answer. You have to say the answer is almost everything is here. You can refer it, but don't just copy paste. You read it and then you try to write it without seeing the answer here, but answers are here, no worries. Aina saatu, you are in the starting of the Arabic, right? Whenever you read, put the haraka. Whenever you write, put the haraka. Don't stop like aina saa, aina yasir, don't stop it. If you practice like that, then we may not understand what is the rule in that place. Why there is a rafa dhamma here? Why there is a kasra here? So just give the haraka whenever you read or whenever you write. Right? Especially for the last letter of the word. You should give the haraka. Aina sa'atu? Where is the watch? Aina yasirun? Aina aminatu? Here you have to give aminatu. Zainabu. Okay? Aina yasirun? Don't say yasiru. If you say yasiru, it's grammatically wrong. Aina yasiru? Where is the yasir? Aina aminatu? Where is amina? Okay, come here. A'aminatu fil ghurfati? Here we have a'aminatu fil ghurfati is amina in the room? No, she is in the kitchen. So how do we answer it? La means no, correct? La means no. She is in the kitchen. How do we write it? She here. She means here. Here in the kitchen. In means what? Fi. Kitchen is in the kitchen. The kitchen means matbakh. Mim ta ba kha. Okay. Fil matbakhi. Why? Because harful jar. So fil matbakhi. La hiya fil matbakhi. No, she is in the kitchen. Next. Ayasirun fil matbakhi. I think he is in the hammam. Hammam means bathroom. So answer it. Maybe same pattern. Instead of here, you have to put huwa. Yasirun is masculine. Man fil ghurfati. You have to answer it. Man fil ghurfati. Who is in the room? Fil ghurfati. You have to write the kasra. Man fil ghurfati. Who is in the room? You have to say so and so person is in the room. You just fill up this, then put this here, finish. For example, Zaidun. Zaidun was not there. Just I'm saying, Zaidun fil ghurfati. But you have to follow this. Here is Muhammad, if I'm not wrong. Muhammad is in the room. So you have to fill up the name, then put this in the room. Muhammad is in the room. That's it. Waman fil hammami wa, and who is in the bathroom? Who is in the bathroom? Answer it. Mada al maktabi. Mada means what? Mada means what? What is on the table? Ala means on the table. Ala is harful jar. So maktabi. Mada, what? Actually, tha is added. That's it. Ma means ma is muka, ma dhalika means what is that? Mada also same. Mada al maktabi. What is on the table? Okay, you answer it. So and so object is on the table. On the table, it is already here. You just bring it. You have to fill up this. Okay. Mada ala sariri. And what is on the bed? Mada, what is on the bed? Ala sariri. It's because ala is harful jar. Ala is harful jar. What is on the bed? Fill up it. Das is on the table, on the bed. So you just bring it here. Okay. Think cool. You can identify it. You can answer it. Next. Iqra waktub ma dhabati awakhir al kalimati. Iqra, read. Waktub, and write. And write ma'a, with. Ma'a, with. Dhabati means mentioning, putting. Awakhir al kalimati, stating. Okay. Awakhir al kalimat, ending of the words. Awakhir al kalimati is because of the some other rule. Okay. We will learn it later. Dhabati awakhir al kalimati. Ending is here. Kalimat is word. Ending of the word. Ending of the words. Read and write the with stating the ending of the words. Ending means haraka. You have to give the haraka. So here you have to practice where to give dhamma, where to give kasra. Everything is, we have already learned madrasa, madrasa, bait, bait, al-ghurfatu, hammamu, matbakhu, maktabu, maktabu, kursiyu, chair, sariru, kitabu, masjid, okay? But there are few is followed by harful jar. So you have to identify whenever you see the harful jar, you have to give the kasra to the following noun. If don't have a harful jar, you have to give dhamma. So you have to write it and read it. Write with the meaning and read it also with the meaning. Inshallah, we will continue the lesson, exercise 3 tomorrow, inshallah. Okay. Today's exercise is exercise 1 and 2 with recording also. Read and write, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. Inshallah, we will see tomorrow.